What others would be saying that you can reestablish society in harmony with the law of God. Absolutely. And now we're down to verses 25 and 26, where the reestablishment of the civil order of Israel is clearly mentioned. Chapter 7, verses 25 and 26. It says, and you, Ezra, according to your God-given wisdom.
And you, Ezra, according to your God-given wisdom. Set magistrates and judges.
Set magistrates and what?
That's the mission of
Israel. Is it authorizing to reestablish the civil order as well as building the city? Absolutely. That has been taken away by Nebuchadnezzar. In fact, Nebuchadnezzar has taken away the sovereignty of Israel 19 years before the city was destroyed. It was actually withdrawn in 605. The city was destroyed in the year 586. So it says, in you, Ezra, according to your God-given wisdom, set magistrates and judges who may judge all the people who are in the land of the unbelievers. All such, and listen to this, as know the laws of your God. By whose laws is this area going to be
judged? You, Ezra, according to your God-given wisdom, set magistrates and judges who may judge all the people who are in the region beyond the river.
Those who do not know them.
Such is the laws of your God.
Punitive measures to be taken against anyone who does not obey these laws. Because it says, whoever will not observe the law of your God and the law of the king, let what? Judgment be executed speedily on him, whether it be death or banishment or confiscation of goods or what? Or imprisonment. Is Artaxerxes authorizing the civil order to be reestablished once again according to the laws of the God of Israel? Absolutely. It is the only decree that fits with the criteria, both chronologically and with the duties and the work that needed to be performed to restore and rebuild Jerusalem. Now somebody might be asking, Pastor Bohr, how accurate is the date 457 as the date for this decree of Artaxerxes? The fact is, the Bible says that this was given in the seventh year of the reign of Artaxerxes. This date is one of the most firmly established dates of antiquity. In fact, there was a book written several years ago. It's called The Chronology of Ezra 7 by Stephen Horn, an archaeologist, and by Kenneth Wood. And in this book, unfortunately, it's out of print. They draw on historical, biblical, archaeological, and astronomical data to prove, shadow of a doubt, that 457, was the date when Artaxerxes gave his decree to restore and to build. So we can know that the 7-month prophecy begins in the fall of the year 457. The moment we're going to see the reason why, we know it was in the fall.
September 25th. You can do as long of an announcement. Hey, start practice. Start.
So,
hearing goes 7 weeks or 49 years, the restoring and the building of Jerusalem was going to be done how? In very troublesome what? In very troublesome times. And if you read the book of Ezra, you will have all sorts of opposition to the rebuilding and restoring of Jerusalem. Those who had stayed back in the land fought tooth and nail so that it would happen. They certainly were troublous times. But now notice that it says that from the going forth of the word to restore and build Jerusalem until Messiah the priest, there shall be 7 weeks, which has to do with the reestablishment of the civil order and religious order of Israel. And after 62 weeks, you come to whom? You come to the arrival of the Messiah. Now the question is, what does the word Messiah mean? The Hebrew word Mashiach means anointed.
Are you going to do your announcement to
it
the YouTube
anointed.
Audience?
And so we need to find out what was the act that anointed Jesus Christ. Now you notice that it says, until Messiah the Prince, right? So he has two names. He's called Messiah, and he's called what? The Prince. There's no doubt whatsoever that the Prince is Jesus Christ. He's called by different names in the book of Daniel. He's called the Prince of the Host. We already studied that. He's called the Prince of the Covenant. He's called Michael, the Great Prince. And in Daniel 8, he's called the Prince of Princes. In the prophetic chapters of Daniel, excluding the historical chapters that talk about the princes that serve Nebuchadnezzar, but in the prophetic chapters of Daniel, every single time the word prince appears, it applies to Jesus Christ. There is no exception to the rule. In other words, this prince is none other than who? Than Jesus Christ. In fact, Isaiah also called him the prince of peace. So there's no doubt whatsoever about who this Messiah, the Prince, is. Now the question is, the word Messiah means anointed. When was Jesus anointed? Well, let's go to John chapter 1, verse 32. John chapter 1 and verse 32.
In the cold.
Here it's speaking about the baptism of Jesus, which marks the beginning of his ministry. John 1 and verse 32. And John bore witness, saying, I saw the Spirit descending from heaven like a dove, and he remained upon him. Is this referring to the baptism of Jesus, where the Holy Spirit fell upon Jesus? Absolutely.
You get that white candy doctor.
Now, verse 41. Just a few verses after this, Andrew speaks to his brother Peter. And I want you to notice what Andrew says to Peter. This is immediately after it speaks of